the Max Stern Athletic Center of Yeshiva University. It's the 25th annual Red Sarachek Tournament on Max Live.
It's a steal. Tsion going the other way. Too easy. I think he just dunked it. It's a throwdown for Daniel Tsion.
Bentley, hard drive, gets into trouble, finds Mason. Mason again! You betcha!
He played the patience to do it. Couldn't do it there. And Bokar will go up for the dunk! Yes!
Shine to Ben Ami. Great bounce pass. Lifeberg, you know you're not going to stop him.
Tucker looking to take him. Goes with the left hand. Running floater. And he gets it in!
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the main event. I'm Oren Glickman alongside my partner, Avi Matanki, and we are thrilled to bring you Max Live's exclusive coverage of the Tier 1 Championship game here at the 25th Annual Red Sarachek Tournament. The Max Stern Athletic Center is buzzing with anticipation as the pre-tournament favorites, the 31-0 DRS Wildcats from Woodmere, New York, put their unbeaten record on the line against the number 3 seeded Shal Hevet Firehawks from Los Angeles, California. Avi, it's often said that good teams find ways to win. That's the optimistic view of DRS performance so far in this tournament. The pessimistic view is that they're barely scraping by and now they face their toughest test yet. What do you think?
Well, Oren, when you take a closer look at these two teams, and how they arrived in the championship game, you couldn't have more of a contrast in stories. The DRS Wildcats came into this tournament with high expectations. They barreled through the Yeshiva League opponents all season long, led by their star, Gabe Lifeberg, and arrived at the Max Stern Athletic Center with a perfect 29-0 record. Many, and myself included, expect them to keep up this dominating pace throughout this tournament. Now, after two underwhelming performances, the first, a three-point victory over Yeshiva League foe TBC, and the second, a one-point squeaker over Sarachek powerhouse TUA, their ability to take home this championship has come into question. On the other side, we have the Shal Hevet Firehawks. The Firehawks arrived in New York City with a 24-6 record, playing in the competitive Mahan Conference in Los Angeles. Ranked the number 3 seed by the Sarachek Ranking Committee, the expectations were that Shal Hevet would be a competitive team but would have a tough road to the championship game, with some even saying that their number 3 seed was undeserved. What has transpired here on the Wilf campus of Yeshiva University has been anything but, with Shal Hevet being the team barreling through the competition with two decisive and dominating victories over Yeshiva High School of Boca and the Frisch School.
Each of these teams has depended on a forward to carry the bulk of their scoring load. For DRS, that forward is, of course, Gabe Lifer. And for Shal Hevet, it's Jacob Dower. What can we expect from these two today?
Well, these two big men have really had their way in this tournament. This is the 6'4 Lifer's second year competing in the Sarachek tournament, and he has become known for his incredible combination of size, skill, and talent. That talent has been evident throughout this tournament as he leads his team in scoring with 15.5 points per game. He has been able to score from behind the arc, down low, and with a great mid-range game. What we have yet to see from Lifer is consistency on offense as teams have been double-teaming him these last two games. On the other end, the Shal Hevet Firehawks with the 6-foot Jacob Dower. The senior forward has led his team in scoring in both of their games and shined in yesterday's Tier 1 semifinal matchup against Frisch with 20 points. Dower, an undersized big man, has been able to dominate his opponents with a lethal mid-range jumper. Shal Hevet's coach Coleman told us before this tournament that Dower is the senior leader of this team and that he plays well. And that when he plays well, the Shal Hevet team plays well. And that has been evident through their first two games.
When we return, we'll have a special interview with President Joel. If there's ever a time for those guys to shine, it's today as the national spotlight shines on DRS and Shal Hevet. When we come back, the best of the West faces the beast of the East right here on Max Live.
I came to IU to pursue a further Jewish education. Participating in a collegiate athletic team has been challenging. Yeshiva University provides an incredible opportunity to find a balance between academics, athletics, extracurriculars. Fellow students show their pride for their teams in coming to games like Max Madness, our senior night, wearing their blue and white colors. The Yeshiva University Athletics Department breaks the stereotype of what it means to be a Jewish athlete. So while I came here for a Jewish education, I'm walking away with much more.
Welcome back to Max Live at the Max Stern Athletic Center, home of the Yeshiva Maccabees and the Red Sarachek Basketball Tournament. I'm Avi Matanki, and I'm joined by the president and Brodmann Family University professor of Yeshiva University, President Richard Joel. President Joel, this is the 25th annual Red Sarachek basketball tournament. There are over 300 student athletes competing in this tournament and nearly thousands cheering their team on from the gym or from their homes. What does this tournament mean to Yeshiva University?
Well, the first thing I need to say is I'm sure there are thousands of people watching right now, but I certainly know that your parents are watching. So a shout out to the Matankis in Chicago. Look, this is a wonderful event. I can only do the color commentary on what you all see. The Sarachek tournament really is a fulfillment of when we describe Yeshiva and we say that nowhere but here, that there's no place where we could have a gathering of young, proud Jewish scholar athletes who come together, and it's not just they're playing ball, they're really immersed in the culture of Yeshiva University. We take full advantage of trying to show them that this is a place where they can have all their dreams and they can build the dreams of the Jewish people. And it's a point of great pride to have them here. This is 25 years of Sarachek, and every year it gets stronger and greater. I think it's meaningful that this year we have both the East Coast and the West Coast in the finals, and I'm kind of partial to both of them. In another life, I was the vice president of the Hebrew Academy of Long Beach before there was a DRS, and Rabbi Siegel, who's the head of school of Shel Hevet, partially grew up in my home in Silver Spring, Maryland. So I think I am wonderfully torn about this game, but I think you just look at this crowd and who they are, and we should all feel proud of who we are.
On a similar note, President Joel, this year, the Yeshiva men's Maccabees basketball team hosted their first home playoff game in nearly 15 years. I was here on campus in the gym producing the game for Max Live, and it was something really special to be seen. Aside from the game itself, with the Maccabees won, during the pregame, it was emotional with over 1,000 people joining in to sing Hatikvah. Why is the sports program here at Yeshiva University so important for the university?
Well, first of all, you'll relive that moment in about 5 minutes when this gym sings Hatikvah and the national anthem. And I think that's really meaningful in terms of what we are. People are in all kinds of places in this country at this time. This is a place that really looks to the future, that builds scholar athletes, that says that you have to work for it, but you can have it all. And when I was at the last game that the Maccabees played, and when I was at their season finale, there's just no way that you can't look at these young men and see what they represent in terms of Torah Umada, see who fills the stands. Our last game was away in SUNY Old Westbury, and there were several buses of students that came. That's just an unprecedented thing. Look, you all know this. In many ways, this is the center of our Jewish world. And it's a center of the Jewish world only if we use it to build our future. And it's our privilege to host the Jewish community and hope that it's home for you.
Thank you, President Joel, for your time. I am Avi Matanki, and this is the Tier 1 Championship game on Max Live, featuring number 1 seeded DRS versus number 3 seeded Shel Hevet. We'll be back with the starting lineups and national anthems after this short break.
In Yeshiva University, I've been lucky to be on both the volleyball and the basketball teams. Being on the team has a huge effect on my academic life. The same way that I know I can push myself in athletics, I know I can push myself in academics. Going to Shiurim at night instead of during the day, or going to them during the day when I've practiced at night, the Judaics is not compromised and the Jewish life is not compromised. We go to other schools and we're wearing our Yeshiva University Maccabees sweatshirt and we're playing for Yeshiva University. It feels amazing to know that we're representing this school, that I can thrive academically, I can thrive in my Judaic life, and I can also be on the teams, and I can also be involved in the athletic life. You can do it all here at Yeshiva University.
Starting lineups? I think we should do that.
And we're back here at the Max Stern Athletic Center. We are going to turn it over to the PA system for the pre-game lineups, for the starting lineups of both the DRS Wildcats and the Shel Hevet Firehawks, and for short announcements and national anthems.
Thank you. Here's Rabbi Siegel. Stand up, Rabbi Siegel. You have the head of school, Rabbi Siegel, and Larry Gill. Where's Larry? Larry also, both a great fan, and I'm convinced the future YU parent. So look, my job is to set the stage in the right way. Don't you want to play this game? On our website, we say about Yeshiva University, nowhere but here. And the truth is, where do we as a people gather in a more celebratory way than at the Saracek tournament? And let's take a minute to realize that all of the teams that have played here are champions. And let's realize how great these guys at Max Live are, because it turns it into a true national event. And let's think a little bit about our future and to say, where can you be to be part of your people, to be a leader of your people, to excel in all ways than here at Yeshiva University? And that's why we're so honored to be a gathering place for this. So I want to wish the teams well. I want to wish you well. Everybody's a champion today. And thank you, and enjoy the game.
Welcome to the Yeshiva University 25th Annual Red Saracek Tournament. For our Tier 1 championship game, featuring the number 3 seed, Shel Heaven High School Firehawks of Los Angeles, California. And the Davis Renham Stoller High School Boys Wildcats of Woodmere, New York.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I could have your attention, please rise and turn your attention toward the flags as we have Gedalia, a member of the Y-Studs, one of Yeshiva University's a cappella groups, who will be singing the United States National Anthem and Hatikva.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fights, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs burst. That our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. Kolod balev av penima nefesh Yehudi
Starting lineup for the Wildcats of DRS. A senior standing 5'11", number 5, Zed Benami. A senior standing in foot. 5'9", number 11, Jeremy Brody. A senior standing at 5'9", number 3, Joab Deutsch. A senior standing at 6'4", number 42, Gabriel Leifer. And a senior standing at 6'6", number 21, Judah Levine. The Wildcats of DRS are coached by head coach Avram Stein and assistant coach Jared Stein.
And alongside who was not in action yesterday in their semifinal win over the Frisch Cougars. He is back today, and he is ready to go.
And that's a huge gain for the Firehawks. And even though Zach Miller filled in admirably yesterday in place of Reamer, Reamer is their team leader in assists with nearly 5 per game. It's going to be important for him to make sure he stays hydrated. Hopefully he can remain energetic throughout the game, because it's a huge, huge gain for Shalhevet. And if he can play well, it can only be in Shalhevet's favor.
This is the closest DRS have ever gotten to winning their first Saracek title, reaching the final. Gabe Leifer wins the tip, and here we go. It's Brady with possession. Ben Ami lays it off to Brody. Brody going to make his move. He'll pull it back out. Looking for ideas. Finds Ben Ami. Deutsch pounds it inside to Leifer. Good pass from Leifer to Brody. Extra pass to Levine. He loses the handle, and Shalhevet come up with the turnover.
And their defense there looked ferocious as they put Idan Sokol on Leifer. Didn't give him any chance to touch the ball. Let's see how that continues throughout the game.
Asher Reamer back in action today. He lays it off to Schnitzer, who impressed very well against the Frisch Cougars yesterday. DRS going zone. Stolen by Ben Ami. Turnover apiece. Deutsch looking to push. He'll pull it back out to Brody. More DRS fans in this gym than Shalhevet fans. Nice little give and go there between Gabe Leifer and Jeremy Brody, and the Wildcats are on the board up 2-0.
And if Shalhevet's going to play Leifer that tight throughout the game, Leifer's got to find those open looks for his teammates. That was a great pass by him. Easy 2 points.
Schnitzer now on the other end. Shalhevet, last time they won the Saracek title was back in 2013 when they were led by JoJo Fallis, who now plays his basketball with the Cornell Big Red in the Ivy League. Nice kick out there. Extra pass. Reamer, he'll let it fly. No good. Offensive rebound there to Eitan Halpert. Nice find to 34. Jacob Dower picking up where he left off yesterday against the Frisch Cougars.
And he's played phenomenally throughout this entire tournament. We haven't seen that 3-point game so far in this tournament, but just another tool in his toolbox that he can pull out at any time.
It's going to be Jacob Dower and Gabe Leifer all day. Let's see who can come out on top. Leifer for the response. He got it. Gabe Leifer, nothing but net on the triple.
And his shot is so good. We saw it yesterday in the first half. He hit 3 easy 3-point buckets. It's just smooth off his hands and straight into the basket.
Reamer now on the other end. DRS faithful into it. Dower gets blocked by Ben Ami. Leifer running and gunning down the court. He draws the foul. That's a smart foul there by Asher Reamer.
Reamer getting in Leifer's way before he has the opportunity to get the shot up. It's still early in the game. Plenty of fouls to give. That was the team's first foul. But they're going to need to be careful and make sure that they don't get into too much foul trouble throughout the rest of this game.
Leifer will inbound to Ben Ami. DRS up 5-3 in this Tier 1 final. Levine's going to make his move. Hook shot gets the banker to go.
And Judah Levine, another big man that DRS has on their team. He's played phenomenally throughout this entire tournament, complementing what Leifer brings to the table.
Shalhevet are going to have their work cut out for them, taking on the two-man punch of Judah Levine and Gabe Leifer. Eitan Halpert waiting for Reamer to come closer to him. There always seems to be a successful Halpert on this team. It's been Yussi Halpert, Simcha Halpert, and now it's Eitan Halpert. Schnitzer has a look. He'll take the 3. It's short. Leifer fighting for the rebound. Eitan Halpert wins out. 3 this time from Dower. Gets it to go. Idan Sokol, excuse me.
And this is something we haven't seen from Shalhevet throughout the entire tournament. They're big men shooting 3. So far, they're 2 for 2. If I was DRS, I might have to start rethinking how we're playing on defense.
Brody from mid-range. No good. Nice tap out by Levine. Leifer, he'll try again for three. No good this time. And a loose ball foul on the DRS Wildcats.
A little too strong there for Leifer, went in and out. What I love seeing from Shalhevet so far is the way they're crashing the boards. Even though they didn't get the rebound there, they were down there in the box, boxing their men out. Saw it, I'm seeing on both ends of the court. They're getting second chance opportunities. They're making their offense just flow right after that.
Checking into the game is Elon Glauberman. Shalhevet, the first team to make a move. DRS, they do not go to their bench much.
No, they only have one man who really comes off the bench, and that's Akiva Ackerman. They play with a six-man rotation throughout most of the game. It's going to be interesting to see in a tournament like this, the Saracek tournament, where this is their third game in 4 days. We'll see if they're able to keep up the pace with Shalhevet, who has a big bench, who uses their bench effectively. Hopefully they can maintain their energy, not get tired, and work throughout the game.
Glauberman with his first touch of the ball. Passes it to star player Dower. Schnitzer now at the top of the key. Waiting for his teammates to move around. He's picking out a play. DRS in a 3-2 defense. Dower, nice pass in the corner to Halpert for three. No good. Rebound to Leifer, and here he comes. That's a good pass to Deutsch. Deutsch unable to lay it in. Pile up for the ball. Who's going to win out? Schnitzer does. Schnitzer. That's a good find to Sokol. Sokol short on the attempt, but he'll shoot two at the line.
And that was great point guard play by Schnitzer, recognizing they had the 5-on-4 there as Leifer was making his way down the court, finding Idan Sokol, who Leifer's been guarding so far this tournament. Sokol faked the three, went in for the drive, got contact, and is now going to have two chances at the line.
Idan Sokol at the line for a pair. He is the younger brother of Ariel Sokol, who's on the YU Max basketball team and has also won 3 Saracek titles in his career as Sokol hits the first. And Akiva Ackerman will check into the game for Judah Levine.
And it looks like DRS is opting to go to a little smaller here, try and match up with Shalhevet's offense a little better.
And Sokol able to convert on a pair. 8-7 to the Firehawks. Almost approaching 3 minutes in this first quarter. Ackerman with his first touch, lays it back to Ben-Ami. DRS chance starting to erupt in the Max Run Athletic Center. Leifer posting up, doesn't get the roll, and the rebound falls to Sokol.
I'd like to see Leifer get that a little closer to the basket. He has the size advantage over Sokol. Should be able to get that basket easy.
Good ball movement here from the Firehawks. Sokol, Dower to Schnitzer. Coach Ryan Coleman instructing his Firehawks team to move around the court. Halpert now, he's double teamed. Schnitzer for three. Short, rebound to Ben-Ami. And here comes the star player, Gabe Leifer. Kicks it out to Ackerman. Ben-Ami. And call for the travel is Jeremy Brody.
These Saracek Tier 1 championship games, there's a lot of nerves that the players have. Right now, we're seeing it on the DRS side. We're seeing it on the Shalhevet side. They're not picking their best shots, and they're going to have to calm down a little bit. And usually at the beginning of the second quarter is when we start to see the offense flowing a little better, ball moving around a little better, and better shots being taken.
Turnover this time committed by the Firehawks, and DRS will get the ball back. One sub apiece from both teams. The Firehawks faithful trying to get into it now. It's Brody now. He's calming down his teammates. Ben-Ami. Leifer now. From the baseline. Tried to go for the pass there. Turned over. Shalhevet pushing. Schnitzer unable to lay it in though. And the rebound goes to Brody. And draws an unnecessary foul there. From Elon Glauberman.
Yeah, Glauberman was trying to force him to go out of bounds without the contact. Not generally the best way to go if you want to have your man go out of bounds. Not the best foul. Hopefully he'll try to make it better throughout the game.
Leifer now trying to find Brody down low. Out of bounds. Ball to the Firehawks. Second Sefi Arnan going to check into the game now. About 1:20 remaining in this first quarter of the Tier 1 final. Halpert lays it off to Glaberman. Glaberman down low to Dower. Halpert has a look. He'll take it. It's good. Nothing but net. Eitan Halpert nails the triple.
And Halpert is Shalhevet's leading scorer this season with 14.2 points per game. He has not gotten in a good flow on offense so far this tournament. Good to see him getting a three-pointer right there. Hopefully he can keep up this pace throughout the rest of the game.
Good pump fake by Brody trying to find Leifer. It's stolen, though, by Sokol. Shalhevet can push now. And able to lay it in is Glauberman. Momentum totally on the Firehawks' side right now, Avi.
Yeah, definitely. Halpert made the necessary extra pass to Glauberman right there. It was the smart play. It was the good play. Glauberman was able to get up for the easy two.
DRS, of course, playing with an unbeaten record. They are 31-0. And even if they were to get the job done today, they would still have work to do because next weekend they play the Flatbush Falcons in the Yeshiva League Championship.
Yeah, it's a really interesting storyline. Coming into this tournament, some people were saying that DRS might not be taking it as seriously as some of the other out-of-town teams do because they still have one more big game to go. So it's going to be interesting to see how they approach the rest of this game. Hopefully they take it seriously because this is the national championship we're talking about. This isn't the New York championship. This is the one that counts, the national championship.
Yeshiva League teams 0-3 today playing in this gym. Rambam, Frisch, and MTA all falling. Leifer trying to bully his way in, gets the tip in to go.
And Leifer, the 6'4 big man, he is taller than everyone else on the court. He is longer than everyone else on the court, and he used his size to his advantage there.
Shalhevet will hold for one. 5 seconds remaining. Halpert from way downtown. Short. Dower trying to get it off. And at the end of one, it's a Shalhevet Firehawks 13 and the DRS Wildcats 9. We are going to take a quick commercial break. Welcome back to the Max Stern Athletic Center. At the end of one, it's the Shalhevet Firehawks 13 and the DRS Wildcats 9. Avi, some injury concerns regarding DRS.
Well, it looked like Yoav Deutsch had a little bit of an injury to his eye in the first quarter, but he's back on the court now. Looks like he's going to play it through, and hopefully he'll be good for the rest of the game.
As we said, DRS, they do not go to their bench much. Sefi Arnan is going to get us started in the second quarter. Glauberman will play the point. DRS faithful trying to get the defense chance going here in the Max Stern Athletic Center. Shalhevet taking their time on this offensive possession. Halpert, he was starting to find his stroke towards the end of the first quarter. DRS closing Shalhevet down very well. Halpert looking for ideas. Glauberman now. Guarded tightly by Brody. It's Samuel Ellenhorn kicking it back out to Eitan Halpert. Shalhevet up four. The three-point attempt does not go there for Sefi Arnan. Shalhevet offensive rebound. Unable to convert the three there was number 14 Sefi Arnan. Another offensive rebound for the Firehawks. And Eitan Halpert now will have the ball again. Coach Ryan Coleman trying to tell his Shalhevet players to get more involved and provide more service for Eitan Halpert. Arnan laying it back to Eitan Halpert. Arnan had the look at the three, passed it up. He was closed down by Leifer. That's a good find in the corner to Glauberman. Lets it go. No good, but another offensive rebound for the Firehawks. And it's funny because DRS are taller. Another three-point attempt, no good. And finally, Leifer controls possession for the Wildcats. And Coach Avram Stein wants to call a timeout. He was definitely not happy with that offensive possession there for the Firehawks that worked so well for them.
Clearly not happy. The Shalhevet Firehawks just burned a minute and a half off the clock, got three straight offensive rebounds. They're big men. They may be shorter, they may be smaller, but they know how to box out. Each shot that goes up, not only do their big men box out, but we see the rest of their team crashing for those boards. They are getting team rebounds. It's not individual rebounds, it's team rebounds, and those are, and that's what you like to see from a Shalhevet Firehawks team. And they are in complete control right now. They may have not converted for 2 points there. Hopefully they'll be able to pick that up as the game goes on, but that was essential for how the game is going to go for the rest.
And we saw DRS attempted to go smaller when they brought on Ackerman, and now Coach Stein, he was not happy with that previous set, so now he is bringing on big man Judah Levine back into the game. DRS down four. Brody now instructing his teammates. Watched tightly by Halpert. Ben-Ami had a look, passed up on it, trying to lay it in, no good, and a strong rebound there for Samuel Ellenhorn. About 5:50 remaining in this first half. Shalhevet up 13-9 in this Tier 1 final. Shalhevet have won the Saracek title once. DRS have never won the Tier 1 final or have ever gotten to it. DRS closing Shalhevet down very well here. Sokol going to take it in. That's a good find to Ellenhorn. Pulls it back out. Shalhevet will start all over again. Halpert trying to get by. Almost loses the handle. He does lose the ball. Eventually falls to Brody. Brody will take it down court. He was harassed there by Eitan Halpert, and Halpert eventually draws the foul.
And Halpert playing him like a glove over there. Was a little too physical on that reach-in. Almost had the steal there, but he couldn't convert.
5-16 remaining in the second quarter. DRS off to a little bit of a slow start here. They are trying to complete the perfect season. They'll still have work to do even if they get this win done today. Ben-Ami at the top of the key. Deutsch lays it to Brody. Brody thought about the three, instead passes to Leifer. Leifer finds himself in a double team, passes it back to Brody. Brody trying to reconnect with Leifer, does so. Leifer still in a lot of trouble. Deutsch now with the pump fake. He'll shoot from the free throw line. It's short. Ben-Ami with the offensive rebound. Leifer now pulls it back out to Ben-Ami. Loose ball. Who's going to win it? Leifer eventually is able to recover. And it's turned over. Levine cannot handle the pass.
And with Leifer being double teamed on every time he touched the ball, DRS's offense does not know what to do. They go through Leifer, and when you shut down Leifer, the rest of them just don't roll.
Sokol now with possession to Arnon. Arnon finds himself some space, able to pass it to Zach Muller, who tries a three, can't convert, but it'll stay with the Firehawks. DRS commit another foul. Asher Reamer is going to check back into the game. You have to think that maybe Coach Coleman is monitoring his minutes because he did not play in that semifinal win yesterday over the Frisch Cougars.
Definitely. We've seen some good minutes from Elon Globerman so far. Now we see that Muller is in for the game. And by the way, Muller is only a freshman. I don't know if you realize that, but he filled in admirably for Reamer yesterday.
Reamer turns it over to Brody. Asher Reamer, the former EULA Panther, played 3 years with the Panthers, here for senior season with the EULA with the Shalhevet Firehawks, as Yoav Deutsch is able to connect on the two. Shalhevet lead down to two, 3:40 left in this first half. Reamer looking for help. DRS picking up the intensity on defense. DRS wanted to travel there. Refs didn't see it. Dower now, haven't seen much of him in this quarter. Glauberman had the look, lays it off to Ellenhorn. Ellenhorn will pull it back out though. Shalhevet having difficulty getting open looks and laying it down low.
They're in no rush now. They're in no rush throughout the game. When they've seen that their offense isn't working the way they'd like it, they try to trim time from the clock, make the smart passes, try to work their offense. You love to see that. It's a little slower pace than what we're used to in the championship game, but it's refreshing nonetheless.
Crowd is becoming impatient. Asher Reamer taking his time on this possession. Of course, there was a lot of controversy in last year's Tier 1 final when Frisch elected to hold on to the ball for an entire overtime period. Dower tries to go for the no-look pass to Ellenhorn, but he can't handle it, and DRS will finally have the ball back. We're at the 2.5 minute mark. DRS can tie the game or even take the lead. Deutsch had a minor injury in the first quarter. He's back though. Ben-Ami. Cross-court pass to Brody. Brody finds Ackerman. Brody could have took the shot there, elected not to do so. Leifer finds himself in another double team. Tries the cross-court pass to Brody. Brody finds an opening. Can't finish though. Ackerman trying to follow his miss, and eventually the ball falls to Shalhevet. Sokol gets fouled.
And Sokol lucked out there just a bit. It looked like they were going to get a jump ball call there, but he ended up moving almost from this angle, from where we're standing, it looked like he tried making the pass and turned it over, but the refs bailed him out with a foul call.
Frustrating for DRS. They're down two. Schnitzer now. Lays it to Reamer. Good feed to Schnitzer. Schnitzer finds Dower. Dower, can he get it going? He'll try a three. Too strong. A nice rebound there by Gabe Leifer. He has numbers if he pushes. And another smart foul there by Shalhevet. That was a great fast break opportunity there for the Wildcats.
And with only 1:35 left in the second period, they still have three fouls to give after that. They still have plenty of opportunities to use their fouls to their advantage. If they see an open man going for an easy layup, an easy basket, they can foul them there, not give up two shots.
Deutsch now with the ball. Swings it to Leifer. Leifer from way downtown. Doesn't get it.
And even though they're only down by two right now, DRS looks a little flustered on offense. They're still well within this game. It's just a one basket possession. I'm not sure why they're trying to rush their shots, not working their offense like we've seen throughout the rest of this tournament.
They have to be happy with the way they've covered Leifer this quarter.
Definitely. The double team has proven to be extremely effective.
Schnitzer short on the three-point attempt. Ben-Ami able to tap it to Leifer. Leifer finds Brody. We're at the one-minute mark in this first half. Shalhevet with a 13-11 lead. A little bit of a slow start to this Tier 1 final. Brody at the top of the key. Brody, he'll try the three off the front iron. Ackerman with the offensive rebound. Nice pass to Deutsch. Deutsch will take it in. The floater doesn't go, but he draws contact, and he'll shoot two at the charity stripe.
And that was a great idea by Yoav Deutsch. Seeing the open lane, driving to the hole, creating contact, and now we'll have two opportunities at the foul line.
This will be a good time to remind our viewers, for all of your players sitting at home or are tired of losing, tired of not being the best, tired of mediocrity, listen closely. There's no other Jewish basketball program that breeds college basketball players, that breeds All-Americans, that breeds 1,000-point scorers, that breeds all-conference players, that breeds fine young men. That's Step It Up Basketball for you. And able to connect on a pair is Yoav Deutsch. Knotted at 13, 30 seconds remaining.
And it looks like Shalhevet is going to call one last play this half.
Shalhevet, they can take the lead going into the break. Of course, no shot clock in the Red Sarachek tournament. And Shalhevet are normally the ones who play with the shot clock back home. DRS don't. DRS almost getting the steal there. Dower, nice pass. Unable to finish, though, is Joseph Schnitzer. Idan Sokol unable to convert. And we are going to go to our sideline reporter, Levy Herman, who is down standing next to Coach Avram Stein. Levy, what do you have for us?
Hi, guys. I'm here with Coach Stein. Coach, congratulations on making it to the finals. It looks like you guys have a lot of pressure coming into the one seed, really highly ranked, and your team is looking great. You have the two big guns down low. How are you looking to keep up this momentum? Right now it's a tie game going into the half.
The whole game is on the defensive end. When we closed them down the last 4 or 5 minutes in the second quarter, we got to rebound better. We got to get the ball into the big guy more.
So on offense, your main goal is you want to try to get the ball to the big man as much as possible?
Absolutely.
Take advantage of your shooters.
Now. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Coach. Send back up to you guys in the booth.
Thank you, Levy. And your halftime score, the DRS Wildcats 13, the Shalhevet Firehawks 13 as well. In this Tier 1 final, we are going to go to our Step It Up Sleepaway Camp basketball halftime show. We'll be back in just a bit.
I came here from...
Welcome to the Step It Up basketball halftime show on Max Live. Are you ready to step it up? Find out at timetostepitup.com.
Step It Up is not your typical basketball camp. We produce unbelievable results. You will get better here. You will get better as a person. You will get better as a player. That's the Step It Up way.
Welcome back to the Max Stern Athletic Center. The halftime score of the Tier 1 final, the Shalhevet Firehawks 13 and the DRS Wildcats also 13. I have a special guest in the booth, Mr. Elliot Steinmetz, the coach of the YU Max basketball team. Coach, thanks for coming by. Coach, I got a question for you. Question for you, Coach. This was a very successful season for the YU Max. 2 years ago, your first season coaching, the playoff game. This year, the first round home playoff game, the playoff win. And there's definitely reason to believe that every single year that you're coaching our guys, there's reason to believe that there's always going to be a step up in the right direction. But there won't be a Shia Weiss and a Shelby Rosenberg next season. I'm sure you know that already. But is there still reason to believe and have faith that the team is only going to be getting better?
Of course there is, absolutely. I mean, for us, we had the same problem the year before where everyone was talking about Benji Ritholtz and he wasn't going to be back. Leading scorer in the conference. Last year, Shelby and Shia stepped up, obviously. We're trying to build a culture. And when you're building a culture, it's something that you can continue every year regardless of who's there. So we'll have guys who will step up next year, whether it's Mike Berg, whether it's some of our freshmen from this year who came in, you know, Jordan Hode, it can be Judah Cohn. We have a lot of guys who can play. So we're confident that we'll be able to take that step.
And now, Coach, turning to the Red Saracek tournament, what is your opinion? How important is it to this university that this is the 25th year? It's really big and a big sense of pride for the university, isn't it?
I think it's fantastic. I think it's great that we have all these high schools out here. Not just the players, but the coaches have an opportunity to see what's going on here. The parents that are here, there's tons of parents here. You have fans from every school here. I think it's an awesome thing that they're all on campus, and then obviously the Shabbos that we have together is a tremendous experience for them.
And of course, the players every year, you have to think, you're here every year watching the talent, seeing if there are any possible players to come here and play for our Max. Does the style of play get better every single year when you come watch?
I think it has recently, for sure. You know, we were talking about it earlier. It's you're seeing some of these Tier 2 teams now, and they're good. They're real good. So I think the depth of talent has definitely improved. I think a lot more kids are playing ball. I think it's the same thing across the boards in college, too. I think college teams at every level have gotten better. I think high school teams at every level have gotten better. And it flows through here at Saracek as well.
And Coach, now turning to the Tier 1 final, the halftime score. It's been a little bit of a slow start, but it looks like it'll be a fun finish. I'm not asking you for your prediction, but DRS and Shalhevet. DRS fighting for an undefeated record. Shalhevet, they've been overlooked a little bit, but they've shown that they can play basketball. And I know Gabe Leifer is someone who you've had your eye on for a while. What are your thoughts? What do you think is going to happen in the second half?
So Shalhevet's been an impressive team to watch here so far. That's a real good team. Those kids are tough. They're tough. They fight every possession. They play hard, and they make shots. And I think we talked about it earlier. I think this is the toughest match DRS has seen all year, and probably at this point we'll see all year. They only have one more game remaining. So, 13-all at the half is obviously not the exact style of ball we like to watch. We'd love to see a little bit of a shot clock situation, maybe a little bit more scoring. But it's definitely a fun game, and I imagine it'll continue to be in the second half.
Coach, thank you so much for coming into the booth, and best of luck with your off-season plans. We look forward to another successful MAC season.
Quick shout-out to my guys at Rambam, my alma mater, Rambam Asifta, 3-1 in the tournament, a nice second-place finish in Tier 2, 11-1 all-time in Saracek.
And we are going to take a quick commercial break. The halftime score, DRS and Shalhevet tied at 13. When we come back, Avi Matanky and I will recap the first half and bring you the second.
In Yeshiva University, I've been lucky to be on both the volleyball and the basketball teams. Being on the team has a huge effect on my academic life. The same way that I know I can push myself in athletics, I know I can push myself in academics. Going to Shiurim at night instead of during the day, or going to them during the day when I've practiced at night, the Judaics is not compromised and the Jewish life is not compromised. When we go to other schools and we're wearing our Yeshiva University Maccabees sweatshirt and we're playing for Yeshiva University, it feels amazing to know that we're representing this school. I can thrive academically, I can thrive in my Judaic life, and I can also be on the teams, and I can also be involved in the athletic life. You can do it all here at Yeshiva University.
Welcome back to Max Live's coverage of the Tier 1 final. I'm Oren Glickman alongside Avi Matanky. Avi, first half thoughts, because during the pregame, two people that you and I hyped up were Jacob Dower and Gabe Leifer, and both teams have done a pretty decent job covering both of them.
Definitely. So far, it's a low-scoring game, 13-13 tied at the half, and I think that's somewhat indicative of those two big men. On the one hand, we have Dower on the Shalhevet side. He scored an early three, and we thought we were going to see him explode for another big game. But since that three, he hasn't scored since. And on the other end, Leifer, their 6'4 big man, who has been dominant throughout this entire tournament, although he really hasn't ever gotten into an offensive consistency throughout, he only has 5 points. The Shalhevet Firehawks are double covering him on each time he touches the ball, clearly disrupting his flow of the game, clearly disrupting his offense. He has not been able to respond so far with any easy baskets.
And Shalhevet also not scoring any points in the second quarter. It has to be due to the fact that they held the ball a lot for long periods of time, and they have to do it differently. They have to push the ball a little faster, don't they?
Yeah, it's something we didn't actually realize until reviewing the stats at halftime, that Shalhevet didn't score a single point. We'll talk about that soon, but we're first going to go to our sideline man, Shimi Warso, who is with Coach Coleman on the Shalhevet sideline.
Coach, you've only seen them come out with six guys, mostly through the tournament. Do you assume they're going to come out with six guys the rest of the game, and you've seen everything they've had?
Absolutely. We know they're not deep. We need to speed up the pace of the game and pressure them a little more and try to wear them down.
All right, thank you very much, Coach.
No problem.
Back to you guys.
Thank you, Simi. We are about to get the second half underway. DRS and Shalhevet knotted at 13. DRS, they have never won a Saracek title. Their best finish was fourth place, and that was last year. And Shalhevet winning back in 2013 when they were led by JoJo Fallis.
And since that game that DRS played last year, they have won 31 straight games. That game, they lost to EULA. Shall have a team, another Los Angeles team, end this amazing win streak? Going to be interesting to see.
And of course, there's always the competition, Avi, of New York and LA. Who provides the better basketball talent?
East Coast versus West Coast ball. From what we've seen at Saracek, if that's indicative of anything, in the last 18 Saracek tournaments, 12 of them have been from out of town, with the majority of those 12 actually being Los Angeles teams, whether it's been EULA or Shalhevet. Shalhevet won just a few years ago, looking to repeat that now. Totally different team from what we've seen then. All those players have graduated, but they're putting on a good show today.
Both teams are going to go with their usual starting five. Zevat Ben-Ami will get us going. Lots on the line here. The second half begins now on Max Live. Ben-Ami will inbound to Brody. And Brody will be watched tightly by Eitan Halpert, the junior. Leifer posting up, finds himself in another double team. The cross-court pass to Brody. Brody tries to pound it inside to Levine. Unable to get it to go, but he will shoot two at the line.
And it looks like DRS is trying to get that ball down low to their two big men. Haven't been so successful with Leifer so far, so going to Levine right now. That was a careless foul by number 45, Idan Sokol, giving Levine two opportunities at the line.
And you have to assume that Coach Stein is going to go with Levine more, because when they had Ackerman come on for Levine, they really struggled to really grab those deep defensive rebounds and providing so many second chance points opportunities with the Shalhevet Firehawks.
Yeah, it looks like they're trying to be proactive instead of reactive, using their size advantage to their advantage instead of trying to match up with the smaller Shalhevet team.
We'd love to hear your feedback on the Clipped Keep Us inbox. Schnitzer lays it to Reamer. Reamer finds Dower at the top of the key. He had a quiet first half. And we have a tie up. But it'll stay with the Firehawks.
And it looks like DRS has come out with a lot of ferocity on defense. Ganging up on Reamer right there for the jump ball. We'll see if they can continue this play throughout the rest of this quarter and the rest of this game.
Back out top to Halpert. Halpert to Schnitzer. Halpert has the ball again. Passes to Reamer. Halpert now. Dower has to get going. When he plays well, the whole team plays well, as Coach Coleman has said repeatedly over the course of this tournament. Halpert down low to Dower. Reamer. Halpert trying to find Schnitzer in the corner. Leifer has him covered. Halpert from way downtown off the front iron. And the rebound eventually falls to Gabe Leifer.
And it looks like DRS has switched to a 2-3 zone this quarter. Clearly frustrating and confusing the Shalhevet offense. Going to be interesting to see what they do from here on out.
Great defense by Halpert. Trying to draw the charge. Doesn't get the call. Ben-Ami from downtown. Unable to hit it. Levine on his miss. And he'll go back to the line. But he's not the strongest free throw shooter.
And if you're Shalhevet, that's the man you do want to go to the line. The one who's not going to make every free throw. If he's going to keep finding himself at the charity stripe, he needs to take advantage of it. He needs to make his foul shots. He's already making his presence felt here in the third quarter. But if he's going to stay in, if he's going to be effective, he needs to be able to convert at the line.
And Levine able to get the first score of the second half. DRS now has a 14-13 lead with 6:34 remaining. Levine for a second. Splits the pair. Dower wins the board. Schnitzer will lay it to Reamer. Schnitzer will play at the two. He did play point guard a little bit in the first win yesterday.
With Reamer out, he came in and filled in admirably. We saw him playing the point guard last year. And so far this tournament, although they haven't had to rely on his ball handling skills, he did a great job.
Reamer, nice bounce pass there to Halpert for the reverse. He gets it. Eitan Halpert.
And with Dower not having much impact on offense so far, we're gonna need to see more of Halpert having an impact, being a force on offense. He has not yet gotten it going this tournament. Gonna be interesting to see how the second half goes.
That's good hustle there by Brody. Ball falls off a Shalhevet player. It'll remain with the Wildcats. Ben-Ami will bring it back in. Trying to find Leifer. Leifer is hounded by Sokol. And a loose ball foul. That'll be the 13th foul committed by the Firehawks.
It looks like Halpert tripped over there. just a bit as he was going to swat away the ball. I think if there wasn't that contact made between their feet, would have been okay. The rest would have let it go.
Ben-Ami will inbound again. Trying to find an open DRS teammate. Gets it in Brody. DRS faithful now. They are chanting their school's name. Deutsch, he'll try from way downtown. No good. Offensive rebound from Levine. Can't put it back. And the defensive rebound goes to Sokol.
And Levine needs to convert. This is the third straight possession where he's gotten the ball on a second chance opportunity. First time he got to the line, missed both. Second time he got to the line, only made one of two. And here he just missed the easy layup.
Dower passes to Reamer. Reamer trying to find an opening. Takes it to the hole. No good. And Ben-Ami will collect the defensive rebound.
There's a nice idea by Reamer, but he wasn't able to convert.
Shalhevet getting back well. Leifer, nice pass to Brody. Finds Deutsch in the corner. Deutsch from mid-range. Off the mark. Leifer trying to tip it in, unable to do so.
And it looked like DRS tried to force the ball in there. Never really set up their offense.
And Halper is able to draw contact. And he will shoot two at the line. The DRS fans are not happy with that call.
It looked like he was on the floor. I didn't really see him getting into his shooting motion. What do you think, Oren?
I have to say, I have to disagree with you, Avi. I think Halper got up there, set the motion in time, but I stand corrected. It'll be an inbound. Globerman finds himself in a double team. Halper will back it out. Shalhevet with a one-point lead with about 4:45 remaining in this third quarter. Halpert, we know he has range. Didn't want to take it there, though. Schnitzer, a little quiet today. Good ball movement from the Firehawks. Can't convert on the three as Sokol. A strong rebound there by Deutsch. Leifer now driving, getting it to go in the foul. Gabe Leifer, he is an animal.
We just saw that eye of the tiger. Leifer knows his team has not been getting it going here in the third quarter with only 1 point so far. He had that look on his face, so he just went to the basket, took over, created contact, and got the easy basket, and will now have an opportunity for the third easy point.
When he sees that things are not going his way, he will all of a sudden just take over a game all by himself. He is that good.
Definitely is. He is the most talented player that we've seen in this tournament. Teams have been hounding him on defense by double-teaming him in each game, so he has really not had a chance to get it going, but we'll see how this second half plays out for him.
A little clear up from the refs. Leifer will shoot his free throw now to complete the three-point play. Got it. He is usually money at the free throw line. MVP chants erupting. Globerman lays it off to Schnitzer. Shalhevet have to get looks. They find themselves down two now. Ben-Ami almost comes away with the steal, but it falls out of bounds. Shalhevet get away with one there.
And Zev Ben-Ami is a player to watch throughout the second half. He has had an extraordinary tournament on both ends of the floor, making clutch plays both on defense and on the offensive end.
Schnitzer finds Globerman. Reamer taking a rest. Sokol trying to... And it falls off Jacob Dower. It'll stay with the Firehawks again.
Hands up, defense!
Sokol was going for the no-look pass there. Leifer able to tip it and guide it to Levine. Leifer now on the other end. He is getting going now, Gabe Leifer. Gabe Leifer is pumped. Total momentum swing now to the DRS Wildcats up 19-15.
He has completely taken over this game. Shalhevet was in control in the first half. Gabriel Leifer said, nuh-uh, no more. I am taking over this game, and I'm going to get us the lead.
19-15 to the DRS Wildcats. 3:49 remaining. That's a smart timeout by Coach Ryan Coleman. You must think he just wants to stop the bleeding right now and talk to his players on how to, you know, they're making it too easy for Gabe Leifer. He is just driving, penetrating, uses his athleticism and muscle to get those points in the paint.
Definitely. We saw them in the first half working their offense to perfection. They may have not converted on a few of those possessions, but they were making the crisp passes. They were making the right decisions. They were taking the right shots. They just weren't able to convert. In this quarter, what we've seen so far is them making lazy passes. Them, the passes keep getting deflected by the longer, stronger DRS Wildcats. They need to make smart decisions, either work the ball down low to Dower, who, even though he's overmatched, has a lot of skill, has a great turnaround fadeaway shot. Either that or working on the outside. We've seen every single player they have on the court has three-point range. They are filled with talent, both in their starting players and on their bench. It's going to be interesting to see how Shalhevet recoups from that timeout.
It's pretty simple for the Shalhevet Firehawks. If they don't stop Gabe Lifer, they don't win the Tier 1 title. Schnitzer now. Shalhevet need a response badly. DRS have all the energy right now. Schnitzer now pulls it back out. Looking for some ideas. Shalhevet look out of sorts right now. Sokol and Dower, they need to start posting up down low, and a turnover by Schnitzer, he traveled.
And not what Coach Coleman wanted to see from his team coming out of the timeout. One of those silly mistakes that players often make, but not that you want to make in a close game like this.
Lifer able to get it down court. And
we've been told by our producer, Asher Goldberg, that we actually have a live feed of the DRS school watching the
Brody hits the three as you're mentioning that. Leading right now with about 2:40 remaining in this third quarter. They need to finish strong as it's stolen by Lifer. Brody is fouled. And that is the 15th foul in the Shalhevet Firehawks, opposed to only one team foul committed by the Wildcats.
And that just looked like frustration from Elon Globerman. The team has only scored 2 points. 2 points in the last 14 minutes. They went scoreless in the second quarter. They've only scored 2 points here. They're down by seven, and it's looking like a tough task for the Shalhevet Firehawks.
Deutsch now for three. No good. Offensive rebound. Levine will kick it back out to Brody. Lifer will try a three now. He got it. Gabe Lifer. He is on fire. The guy can't be stopped.
And Gabe Lifer is taking over this game. We heard about this talent for the last 2 years. We have not seen this much talent in the Max Stern Athletic Center at the Saracek Tournament in years.
DRS all of a sudden up 10. Now 7. That's a big three there by Eitan Halpert.
And it looks like Halpert's starting to get a little bit of rhythm going. He has 5 points this quarter. He's going to need to be active on offense if Shalhevet stands a chance.
Ben Ami now. DRS will take their time up 7. Brody lays it to Lifer. Lifer thought about his move, needs help, finds Deutsch in the corner. Deutsch will lay it back to point guard Jeremy Brody. Brody watched tightly by Seffi Arnon, can't find an opening. Nice crossover there, able to find space, eventually guides it to Levine. Lifer now, is he going to take the three? Great ball handling skills there to Ben-Ami in the wing. He cans the three. Zeb Ben-Ami, DRS are firing on all cylinders right now.
And they're now up by 10. Zeb Ben-Ami, who we saw make clutch plays throughout this tournament, just hit a huge three there.
Shalhevet, they need to find a way to cut this to single digits to go into the break. Arnon, he'll try a three. He's fouled shooting the three, so he will get three free throws at the line.
And that was a silly play by Zeb Ben-Ami. We've seen him make a lot of great plays on defense. That was clearly not one of them. With his team with the momentum, giving the Shalhevet a little bit of a break. Three free throws here coming. We'll see if this can start Shalhevet on a new streak.
Arnon can't convert on the first attempt.
No. Oren, it's going to be interesting to see if Coach Stein continues to go with these five guys. He has not made a single substitution this quarter.
Arnon now will go to the line for a second. Cans that. And now the lead is down to 9. And Avi, we talked about this DRS Wildcats team being undefeated. Is this one of the best teams we've seen in years at the Red Saracek tournament?
Definitely one of the best teams that we've seen at the Red Saracek tournament. We have not seen the consistency that we would have liked to see. They have faced tough competition. They have so far beaten tough competition, but not in the decisive fashion that we were expecting.
That's a nice take there by Joab Deutsch, and DRS are up 11. DRS, they are just on fire on the offensive end. If I'm Shaul Hevet, I just want to hold for one now. Don't give DRS the ball back.
And it looks like that's what they're going to do.
Schnitzer now at the top of the key. He's got to get going here, or at least play architect with some good passes. Halpert now. 10 seconds remaining. Shaul Hevet. They are being closed down by DRS. Dower for a big three. No good. Defensive rebound to Brody. Heaves it up. At the end of three, it's DRS 30, Shaul Hevet 19, and we are going to go to a quick commercial break. Welcome back to Max Live's coverage of the Tier 1 final. Avi, third quarter thoughts. There's not much to say. DRS totally won that.
Definitely. In the last two quarters, Shaul Hevet has only scored 6 points. In this quarter, while they did give up six, because in the second quarter, Shaul Hevet only had zero, DRS just exploded on offense, gaining their first lead and not looking back, now up by 11 going into the fourth quarter.
How about the big presence of Judah Levine that quarter?
That has been the X factor in this game. We saw Coach Stein opt to get Levine out there, get Levine off the court early, and have Ackerman come in his place. That was not working for DRS. They were stagnant on offense, stagnant on defense. So he decided, let's just go with our size. We know we are so much bigger than Shaul Hevet. They may be more athletic, but if we play a zone defense, if we build on our size, we have a chance to take home this Tier 1 championship.
Shaul Hevet need a flawless fourth quarter if they are going to have any chance of coming back into this game. A little confusion now from the referees.
And it looks like it's going to be DRS's ball. I believe that is the correct call. There was a jump ball in the third quarter. Shaul Hevet got possession on that one. It looks like DRS is going to get this one now.
Ben-Ami tees up Leifer. Ben-Ami now with possession. Trying to set up Leifer. Nice pass from Leifer to Brody to Deutsch. Deutsch finds Levine inside. He'll pull it back out to Brody. DRS can take all their time up 11. Leifer posting up. Trying to find a way in, can't convert. Levine on the follow, count it and the foul.
And that was some poor boxing out by Shaul Hevet. We've mentioned time and time again that DRS has the height advantage, but we saw in the first half that Shaul Hevet was able to crash the boards, box the big men out, and we have not seen that yet here in the second half. And if they're not going to do that, DRS is going to keep dominating on the inside.
Levine can't convert the three-point play. DRS up 13. Schnitzer, boy, they need something from him. Halpert now, handling things. Arnon now. Halpert from way downtown. Rolls in and out. Rebound to Leifer. Nice vision from Leifer to pass it to Deutsch. And Brody will settle it down. Leifer posting up on Sokol. He'll lay it back to Ben-Ami. Nice vision again from Leifer to Deutsch in the corner. No good on the three, though. Trying to follow his miss was Brody, but can't convert. Halpert now. Schnitzer, he'll try a three. No good. Sokol with the offensive rebound. Schnitzer passes to Arnon for three. No good. And defensive rebound to Ben-Ami. He's got no options. and another unnecessary foul there from Schnitzer.
And Shalhevet has not been able to make the adjustments necessary on offense to disrupt the DRS defense. They are trying to force three-point shots. That last possession there looked like there was 10 seconds left, and they were just trying to get up a prayer to win the game. But there is still 6 minutes and 38 seconds left. They're only down by 13. That is plenty of time. We saw them score 13 points in that first quarter. They could do it again here in the fourth quarter and win this game.
But is there a way to find yourself back in the game when Jacob Dower has been completely invisible?
Definitely. With their two big men, with Levine and Leifer, Dower has been nearly silent since the first quarter.
Ben-Ami converts on the front end of a 1-1, and he will get another free throw. It has been the DRS show this second half. Ben-Ami for his second free throw. Book it. The lead is up to 15. DRS's largest of the day. They can smell that first ever Saracek title. Arnon with the ball. Thought about the three, lays it to Halper. Arnon thought about the three again. Sokol now. Can he come up with something? DRS totally executing their defensive plan against the Firehawks. Fade away from Dower, no good. And a monster board there by Gabe Leifer.
And that was a shot we saw Dower not miss yesterday. The turnaround fadeaway jump shot. He was hitting those all day yesterday and on Friday. So far, he has not been able to convert. But if they can get him going, it's going to be scary for the DRS Wildcats.
Nice playing there by Brody. Lays it off to Deutsch. Deutsch. Ben-Ami passes down low to Leifer. Ben-Ami will try a three. He got it. Zeb Ben-Ami drains the triple.
And at this point, it looks like DRS is just running away with the game. An 18-point lead. It's going to be hard for Shalhevet to come back from this.
Nice take by Eitan Halpert. The basket will be good, and he will go to the line and try to complete the three-point play.
Halpert's play, although impressive, has not been enough for Shalhevet today. He has finally found a little bit of an offensive rhythm. I think he only had 9 points coming into this game in two total games. I think he's matched that here today. But Shalhevet still down by 16, 5:34 left to go. Plenty of time, but they're going to need to get a lot of stops on defense and make a lot of plays on offense.
Halper to complete the three-point play, you betcha. A big play they needed there from Eitan Halper. DRS still up comfortably, up 15. That is the eighth team foul committed by the Firehawks, and DRS are getting trips to the line already.
Yeah, and that was point guard Zach Muller who came in for Schnitzer, who looked like he got a little shooken up before. Muller, just a freshman, probably not the smartest foul. He's still gaining experience. They're going to have 3 more years left of him on the Shalhevet team. Hopefully he can make better decisions in years to come.
Brody can't convert. Rebound to Muller. Arnon, he'll slow it down. Muller, can the freshman come up big here? Halper dishes to Arnon. Dower just hasn't been able to get going today. Shalhevet cannot take their time. Arnon, nice pump fake. Jumper doesn't go though. And a foul committed by Ackerman. Shalhevet will still have the ball. That is only the 14th foul though committed by DRS.
DRS has just been playing phenomenal defense this entire half. They have not been making silly mistakes. They've been pounding on defense, using their length to their advantage like we just saw right there.
The wingspan of Gabe Leifer. He's able to steal. Stolen back by Dower, though. Denied by Gabe Leifer. And the ball will go back to the Firehawks. 4:54 remaining. Is there enough time for Shalhevet? Down 15 in this Tier 1 final. And we have a timeout on the floor with 4:54 left. Avi, you have to assume that Shalhevet, they really have to start putting up some decent shots from the outside and respond with some turnovers the other way.
Since DRS switched that 2-3 zone, Shalhevet has not found a way to convert on offense. We've seen only 9 points this half. Clearly frustrated, not being able to get good passes out. DRS, the length of Levine, of Leifer, has been so frustrating to the Firehawks offense. They keep getting passes deflected, keep getting passes stolen. They're going to need to figure out a way to make the smart pass, find the open man, and get easy shots. There's still 4:54 left. We've seen crazier things here in the Max Stern Athletic Center, but it's not looking good. The Shalhevet fans looking a little demoralized. Shalhevet bench looking a little demoralized, but they can't give up yet. There's still plenty of time to go.
And we got word from our sideline reporter that Coach Coleman is going to instruct his players to either foul Brody or Levine. Unable to get the roll on the three-point attempt was Halpert. Levine comes up with the rebound. And DRS can milk some more clock up 15. Leifer lays it off to Levine. And Coach Coleman, that's what we heard they do, and they've done it. They fouled Judah Levine, and Judah Levine will shoot 1-1 at the line.
And we're hearing from our sideline that Shalhevet Coach Coleman has told his team to keep fouling Levine on the DRS side. Levine, we've seen, is not a great free throw shooter. Going to be interesting to see if he can keep converting at the free throw line. So far, he is 1-for-5 for today. We're going to see. It sounds like he's going to get a lot more opportunities at the line. If he can convert, it's going to be DRS's game easy. If he can't, we might be in for a great comeback from Shalhevet.
One more foul, though, and DRS will already find themselves in the double bonus.
And that means two shots, no questions asked for DRS. It's a lot of opportunities.
That's a big free throw there from Levine. He rattles it home, and he'll get another. That plan backfired by Coach Coleman. Levine, able to hit a pair. He buries it, and he is pumped. He knows what Shalhevet we're trying to do, Avi.
And he responded. He has a lot of confidence on this floor.
Halpert lays it off to Dower. It's been the storyline of the day for the Shalhevet Firehawks. Jacob Dower silenced by the DRS Wildcats team. Tries a three-pointer, doesn't go. Halpert swings it to Muller, who dishes to Sokol. Nice find to Dower. Can't convert again.
And Dower there actually had an easy shot to get in. He's been frustrated today. Looks like a little bit of that frustration came out there. Not able to convert on the easy basket.
And Leifer will make another trip to the free throw line.
And it looks like that's the second foul on Zach Muller. Something we haven't mentioned on the broadcast. I know I mentioned that he's a freshman, but what we haven't mentioned is he's actually Adam Muller, the point guard from the Eula Panthers' younger brother.
A lot of connections, of course, between Eula and Shalhevet, arch rivals, both in the LA area. Leifer able to hit his first. And Leifer buries a pair. Very rare that Gabe Leifer misses from the free throw line. 41-22. This has been a spot-on performance from the Wildcats. Three-pointer from Sokol off the front iron. Trying to follow his miss was Halpert. Another rebound for Leifer. Halpert able to keep it in, but it falls to Leifer. Home run pass from Leifer to Ackerman. Ackerman will pull it out. He prefers a DRS kill more time. And the last touch is off Ben-Ami. Shalhevet will have the ball. But they don't have plenty of time to work with. They're down 19 with only 3:30 remaining.
They're going to need a miracle.
Halpert finds Dower. DRS faithful. They are partying right now. Muller for three. Doesn't hit. Offensive rebound for Jacob Dower. 3:10 left. Shalhevet try another three. They just can't get it going from three-point land. Leifer running and gunning down the court. Finds Brody. And Brody gets fouled by Globerman.
And it appears that Coach Coleman, aside from Levine, has also instructed his team to foul number 11, Jeremy Brody.
Brody for his first. Count it, nothing but net. And Avi, we really have to talk about DRS now. They barely got by TABC. They barely got by Eula. But this is a championship-type performance from an excellent team.
What we've seen here in the last three quarters has just been utter dominance by DRS, both on the defensive and offensive end. They've made the proper adjustments. They didn't have a great first quarter, but now are playing with ferocity, with tenacity, everything you want to see from a championship team.
Globerman can't hit the three. Ackerman tries to keep it in. Eventually falls to Gabe Leifer. Leifer looking for a teammate, finds Deutsch. And Deutsch gets fouled this time. And down 21, shall Hevitt still elect to play the fouling game?
Down by 21. Doesn't look like there's much they can do at this point. It looks like DRS is probably going to be the 25th champion of the Red Saracek basketball tournament. But it's great to see the effort that they're putting forth, not giving up, doing what they can to still stay in this game.
And Zeb Ben-Ami going to the bench with a standing ovation from the Wildcat faithful. And Deutsch able to hit a pair of free throws. 45-22. DRS have been owning Shalhevet. Nice pass from Halpert to number 12, Derek Orenshine. He can't hit. Leifer eventually gets fouled.
And we haven't seen much of Orenshine this tournament, but it looks like Coach Coleman may be bringing him for a little extra size. He's the tallest player on their team. Maybe trying to frustrate some of the DRS big men a little bit.
Leifer at the line for his first. He's been perfect from the free throw line today. That's his first miss. And of course, DRS, they will be very happy winning the Saracek tournament because it'll be the first ever title they bring back to Woodmere, but there's still work to be done. They want to win that Yeshiva League championship next weekend against the Flatbush Falcons.
Definitely, that's a big game. It also takes place here in the Max Stern Athletic Center. Biggest game of the year for the Yeshiva League. Let's see if they can be a multi-championship team year.
Able to hit the three there is Globerman. And the lead is down to 21 with 2:08 remaining. Coach Coleman will take a timeout. You know, as the president of Max Live, I really want to say thanks to a ton of people, our whole crew. I want, you know, the viewers are the most important people to me. We do this for you. I want to thank everyone who's tuned in from the beginning of that season, that YU home opener against Gallaudet, to all the way now to this Tier 1 final, the Saracek Tournament. It has been an unbelievable Max Live season. I'd like to thank our crew for this game. Jonathan Gardner, Yash Ginsburg, Max Hoffman, Shimi Nabosny, Levy Herman, Simi Warsaw, Yosef Frankel, Mendel Azdoba, Zalman Moses, Gary Fader, Leo Corman, Leora Litwin, Jacob Herenstein, and of course, I want to thank the hierarchy of Max Live, Moshe Cook, Daniel Gordon, Asher Goldberg, and of course yourself, Avi Matanki.
I'm crying over here.
And Benny Statman, I forgot you. I apologize. Brody lays it to Leifer. Attempting to steal is Globerman. It falls out of bounds.
And just to add on to your thing, because I know we thanked him once already, but it goes without saying that Leo Corman, who has produced nearly every game here at the Red Saracek Tournament, along with Leo Litwin, have been doing phenomenal jobs throughout the entire tournament.
Schnitzer can't hit the pull-up. DRS draw another foul, and DRS will get more free throw shooting practice at the line.
At what point do you think Coach Coleman's going to say, there's not much time left on the clock, we're down by a lot, maybe we should stop this fouling game?
If it were me, I would definitely stop right now. Why just continue to let them shoot free throws? You're already down 21. Just go out on a bang, you know? Get some quality baskets. Can't hit on the first is Jacob Deutsch, the younger brother of Yoav.
And it's interesting to note that this DRS Wildcat team, that core six group of six guys, that six-man rotation, they are all seniors this year. After they're gone, we don't know where this team is headed. I'm sure they have a lot of talent in the younger underclassmen, but there's a lot of uncertainty there. For the Shalhevet Firehawks, though, they do have a few seniors on the team with Ashi Reamer, Jacob Dollar, Elon Globerman, Derek Orenshine, and Joe Schnitzer, but they still have a great young core in Halpert, Sokol, and Muller, who will all be returning next year. And as I've mentioned, Muller is just a freshman. He has played phenomenally throughout this tournament, and he filled in admirably for Reamer, for starting point guard Ashi Reamer, who was out with a stomach bug yesterday. And he has also made some big plays here today. So they have a few more years left in this team. Whether it's next year, whether it's the year after, it's going to be interesting to see how this team changes.
And also definitely nothing to be ashamed of from the Shalhevet Firehawks standpoint. People actually overlooked them, complaining that they did not deserve to be a 3 seed, and they proved those doubters wrong by really impressive performances against the YHS Boca Storm and, of course, yesterday against the Frisch Cougars.
Yeah, they dominated those games. They played a great, great tournament. They're playing a great game today. We've seen a lot of good things out of them. Unfortunately, there were just too many things that didn't go their way, so it doesn't look like they're going to come away with the win. But a lot to be proud of, a lot to be happy for if you're the Shalhevet Firehawks.
Shalhevet continuing to foul, and Jacob Deutsch will go back to the line. Able to hit on his first. He rattles it home. And Gabe Leifer is going to the bench to a rounding ovation from the entire Max Stern Athletic Center. It's assumed that he's going to be named the MVP of this tournament.
Yeah, I don't think there's any doubt. He's had a little bit of a rough tournament thus far, not dominating like everyone thought he did, but in this second half, he has done just that. He now has 16 points, 14 rebounds in this game, a huge double-double, and there's no doubt he's going to go away with that MVP trophy.
Orenshine, a couple of consecutive baskets on Shalhevet's previous offensive possessions. 47-29 DRS with 1:17 remaining. DRS's season will not be over yet, though. There's still work to be done if they want to complete that perfect season. They will be playing the Flatbush Falcons in the Yeshiva League Championship next weekend, and you have to assume that they will be overwhelming favorites.
Definitely. After a tournament like this where they showed adversity, they showed the ability to adjust on both offense and defense. This has been a great tournament for them. A lot of us questioned DRS coming into today's game. They didn't dominate like we thought they would in those first two games. But today, they took control after a rough first quarter. We saw their defense turn it up in the second, and we saw their offense just explode in the second half.
And definitely an exciting championship Monday in general. It all started off with Barron knocking off Kohelet for the Tier 4 crown, Eula beating Frisch in the 2014 rematch of the championship game, that Albert Waxman buzzer beater to win the Tier 3 crown for the Fuchsies Rafi Mayhem, and of course RASG knocking off Rambam previously.
And that's Saracek basketball for you. It's always fun. It's always exciting.
Jacob Deutsch unable to keep it in. 102 remaining. Shalhevet, they find themselves down 18.
Play the subs, coach!
Schnitzer will take it down court. Halpert.
Hit the champ.
Mid-range jumper doesn't go there. Rebound to Levine. Ball falls out of bounds. It'll remain with the it'll go back to the Firehawks.
And with the way it's headed right now, it looks like this is going to be the most decisive Saracek Tier 1 championship victory since Ramaz in 2009 defeated MTA with a score of 48-26, a 22-point victory. DRS up now by 18. I don't think they'll get to that 22, but so impressive nonetheless.
46.6 remaining. Muller. Globerman now on the wing. Muller will put one up. Too strong. It'll stay with the Firehawks, though. 34.4 left. A phenomenal Red Saracek tournament this year. It's been very fun calling this game with you, Avi Matanki. Muller, another three. He nails it. But it's the DRS fans making all the noise right now, up 15. And unable to lay it in there. Shalhevet pushing now. Muller will try again from downtown, off the mark. And now Deutsch will dribble out the clock. Looks like that'll do it. The DRS Wildcats are Saracek champions for the first time in school history.
And the DRS team and school storm the court. A lot to be proud of in today's game.
Congratulations to the DRS Wildcats. 47-32 victors over the Shalhevet Firehawks, and they really deserved it. Outstanding, dominating performance, especially in that third quarter.
Definitely amazing zone defense. Amazing offensive sets. Gabriel Leifer getting it going. It was fantastic play from the DRS Wildcats, and they've played fantastically.
And we are here with Judah Levine. We're still waiting for a few more Wildcat players. Hopefully we'll get Gabe Leifer in, Zeb Ben-Ami, and a few others.
And our sideline men are heading up with our mics. We should be able to get going with this post-game interview in just a couple moments.
Definitely a lot to celebrate. And Judah, congratulations. First Saracek title in school history for DRS. I know that you guys are chasing a perfect season. The work is not done yet. You still have the Flatbush Falcons next weekend. But still, to win this title for the school, it definitely feels great, doesn't it? And you guys can start celebrating today.
Yeah, it feels amazing. I'm so happy that we won. One more game until perfection. That's all. That's all it really is. But we need to get it done.
An amazing 32-0. We saw you Wildcats make a major defensive adjustment in the second half, going to a zone. In the second quarter, we saw some pretty dominant defense. You gave up 0 points to the Firehawks in the second quarter. And since that first quarter where they scored 13 points, I believe they finished with 32, so they've only scored 19 points since. Talk about what you guys did on defense. Talk about what you guys tried doing on offense that really worked so well for you guys the second half.
Look at the camera. You go.
What? We just play good defense. We take pride in that, and we work on it every practice, and we just play strong.
And let's get a word with the MVP, Mr. Gabe Leifer. Yeah. Round of applause for this young man. Gabe, question for you. Someone we hyped up during the pregame was Jacob Dower, and we thought that you guys were going to go at it all day, and you guys ended up silencing him. What was the key to that for you?
I mean, the key to it was we knew Jacob Dower was the focal point of their offense. We knew they tried to get in the ball at the high post, so we knew that's what we needed to take away in order to win this game. That's what we did, and that's why we won by 15 points.
And guys, you have the Flatbush Falcons next weekend in the Yeshiva League Championship. They did not play in this Saracek tournament. They will be well-rested. Do you think you guys will be well-conditioned enough to go up against them next Sunday?
Yeah, we just won this tournament. We basically played a game Friday, Sunday, Monday. I think we'll be fine with the rest this week.
Guys, congratulations. First Saracek title in school history for the DRS Wildcats. And best of luck next weekend to complete the perfect season against Flatbush.
I'd like to thank the Lascos for watching on their flight.
And before we let you go, guys, one more thing, guys.
I'd like
guys.
To tell my mom to feel better, thank my dad and my mom for a lot of support, my grandparents, and I love everyone in my family, and if I forget anyone.
Guys, before we let you go, can we get a team dab going?
Yeah!
Let's go!
One, two,
yes!
Thank you. See you Sunday.
And that'll do it. Avi, your final thoughts.
My final thoughts, it was an exciting game, really close in the first half. But DRS blew it wide open in the second. We saw extraordinary play from Gabe Leifer. We saw Levine coming in and making his presence felt on both ends. DRS using their height, using their size, and they just ran away with it.
It's been an exciting Red Saracek tournament. We thank all our viewers for tuning in. And I would like to thank Avi Matanki, the rest of our crew. It's been a phenomenal Max Live season. We will see you next year. Goodbye for now. Have a great day, and we hope you enjoyed watching.